Hey, this is Michael Lindsay from Vital MX. I'm here with Matthias Breyer, who is the marketing coordinator for Shoei Helmets North America. And it's been a while, I think 10 years almost. We have a new VFX, not W, but Evo.
That's right.
People haven't seen it. It definitely has some similarities to the old model, but it is an all new product for you guys. What's going on here?
That is absolutely true. And I'm glad you said it looks like the old Shoei helmet a bit, because it does pay tribute to that design. The VFX series has been the industry leading off-road helmet for a long time now. And this helmet pays tribute to that. So the design complements the design of the W, but also has an edgier, sharper, more progressive design than the previous model does. So yeah, we're really, really stoked to kind of show you guys this new design that's come out. And it looks beautiful, doesn't it?
It does. I think we'll just go ahead and jump right into the deep end of it. You know, every year, whenever new helmets come out, oh, it's got EPS this, dual density this, this, that.
That's right.
Let's talk about the little blue tag here, meds.
That's right,
Everybody's meds. Talking about rotational energy and all that kind of issue with head trauma. And I'm guessing this is your guys' way of combating that in-house at Shoei.
Absolutely. So for the first time ever, we are actually adding a rotational energy management system into our Shoei helmets. The motocross industry specific has really had a following, taken a following to this kind of technology with other brands out there. The difference though is the Shoei way to do it is they've constructed a very sophisticated EPS system here that does the same thing by reducing rotational energy on there, but yet it does not sacrifice any of the main impact absorption performance that we're so known to trust and love with Shoei helmets. So it is going to meet Snell standards. And it will also have a new feature of safety, which is the rotational aspect to it. So meds. Meds means...
A little example up here, probably you can't see what it actually kind of looks like inside. So it's all based more around the top dome area.
That's true. So what it is there's an outer layer of EPS on the outside of the helmet, and there's going to be an inner layer as well. Now the two layers are going to be kind of glued or secured by only a few contact points. So when you have an impact, these two liners are going to actually move independently from each other to help absorb some of that rotational energy. And one of the things we found comparing rotation energy management testing inside our Shoei factories is that the VFX-W and the VFX Evo, the Evo actually had a 15% reduction in rotational energy forces. So we did add a new level of safety performance to this new helmet. So.
Now, moving beyond just meds, what else did you guys actually do? Like I said, we can see that the shell has similarities. There's also some changes. What's different about the shell, the EPS technology that's being used, and the ventilation?
Ventilation has been increased just a bit. It's obviously been optimized in our wind tunnel testing to make sure it performs for the type of riding conditions that we're trying to do. Compared to the VFX-W, the Evo has one additional intake vent and two additional exhaust vents. The additional intake vent is going to be the top one up here, and the additional exhaust vents are going to be cut into the shell out the back right here. To help maximize the ventilation, they've also added very, very large neck roll outlets on the back here to help draw and pull the hot air out. You also mentioned the EPS, and the EPS is very instrumental to our ventilation components as well, because the EPS actually has channels around here to help direct air not just into one area of your head, it's actually directing it around your whole crowns for more optimized, efficient cooling characteristics. So yeah, it's just a great ventilated helmet, and you know, when you're off-road out there doing your motos, it's very important to be cool as possible. It's hot, sticky, and dirty out there, so some our riders really appreciated. The other benefit for the ventilation is the front mouthpiece, which is very uniquely shaped and easily to identify with, but it's been enlarged, so it's larger than it was in the past, and it intakes more air than it has in the past as well. Still gonna get your aluminum mesh guard there and your filter on the inside, but there's also now a shell bracing material across the inside right here, and that's to prevent penetration of a handlebar or some kind of metal object or something to go through there. So there's basically the same hard shell material as a brace right across the back right there. You can't see it, but it does live within there, so a nice little additional safety feature.
So just from a quick glance, the actual foam inside, not the foam, sorry, the liner inside that actually contacts your head, all your padding. You guys still have a quick removal system on the cheek pad. What else about the actual material of this liner? Is there any changes or anything?
Yeah, a bit. They were able to, go ahead and hold that for me.
Yep.
So they were able to add this high sweat absorption material on the top, kind of like an athletic material to help absorb a lot of that sweat, but they also added the softer nylon material on the bottom, the traditional nylons, so it gives it a softer feel when you're putting it on and off your head. Some of the complaints were this material in the past was a bit scratchier and a bit uncomfortable, so now it's much more comfortable and pleasant to put on and off. Again, completely removable, washable, replaceable, customizable. You can get different sizes, different thicknesses. The other additional feature they added in here was these really nice little chin strap covers right here. These little chin strap covers have a lot of perforated holes right here, and that's going to help to cool a key area of your body, which is the throat area, which is going to help you cool your body off.
Now, a big one a lot of people have been talking about lately also is weight. Where are we at weight-wise with this helmet, say a standard medium shell? Do you guys have any info?
I don't have the info on that just yet. However, these first production runs for this show just came in overnight from the shipments, so yeah, we'll have that information very soon. However, what we're looking for is basically an even transition from our previous model, the W, to the new model, the Evo.
I think that's the interesting part. We are here at the display. I know I talked to you guys and we were talking about maybe seeing this before the show. We're seeing it here because, well, you have a plain white one. You guys just barely got the samples. So
yep.
When can people expect to start seeing the graphic roll out on what we're going to get for colors and everything? And also, when can they expect to possibly even be able to buy one?
Absolutely. Right now, we are launching this helmet now. Helmet House, our distributor, will be bringing these in, and we should see them arriving here probably middle of November, probably at the dealerships beginning of December. So it'll be kind of a Christmas present.
Mm-hmm.
Yep, but our athletes like Malcolm Stewart, Dean Wilson, Josh Grant, all those guys will be using it at the upcoming Monster Energy Cup.
Monster Energy Cup debut, mm-hmm. Get to show off some new colorways and designs.
Absolutely, we also have a good few colorways here to show you guys, so you can check them out as well.